Hello my loves, welcome back to another video, and this video is very exciting because it's a collaboration video. Whoop whoop. It's my first ever collaboration with the lovely Journal with Dolly, and her channel is really inspiring and really nice, and she has a similar style to me. She also keeps a Fibonacci and she has a creative journal, and she's just amazing. And we decided that we were going to send each other a bundle of stuff, like a big thing of happy mail, and then make journal pages with only the things that the other one sent the other person. And first of all, those are beautiful rainbow notepad pages, and I just had to stick everywhere. She also sent me so many amazing goodies, and we decided that in this voiceover we were gonna talk about pen pals and snail mail and stuff like that. And I'm really interested to hear what she has to say, but I know I'm gonna talk more about my pen friends or pen pals, I guess more in a traditional way, like we didn't really know each other in person, but we wrote letters to each other and became friends like that. So yeah, I have a lot to chat to you about, and I love getting stuff in the mailbox. I love going to my mailbox and it being full of postcards or letters or packages. That just makes my day. So one of the ways I try and make that happen is I joined Postcrossing very many years ago. So I might have mentioned Postcrossing before, I have a feeling I have, but it's about sending postcards to strangers, and it's about keeping the art of writing postcards alive, and it's been around for over 10 years now, and you sign up for free. And you then click, I want to send a postcard, and you get an address from somebody else who signed up, and then you send them a postcard. And when the postcard arrives, your address will go into the dispenser for another random person to get your address and to send you a postcard. So it's not a two-way thing. It's you send one postcard to one person and another person sends you a postcard. It's not like you get to know a person very closely, but it's a glimpse into other people's lives. You get so many different stories, varieties. You can also say in your like little blurb profile description, hey, I would like you to write in your native language, or I would love to hear some song recommendations, or what's your favorite poem, or stuff like that. So you can make it whatever you want it to be, and I've actually received over 100 postcards since I started, which is a few years ago, and I don't do it regularly. I try to, but I don't do it that regularly, and you only get postcards when you actually send some. So it's not like you don't have to send any and your mailbox just floods with postcards. That's extra not how it works, but I can really recommend it. I've received some beautiful postcards. I started up again a few weeks ago, and it's so, so nice to receive messages from all over the world with stories from people. And I think there was a card from a 13-year-old boy, and there was a card from a grandma telling me about her new grandson. And it was just, it's really nice, and I can really recommend it. And it's free. You just have to pay the postage. The postage has gotten up a lot, generally over the last few years, but a postcard is still pretty cheap to send. So yeah, I just wanted to make that an option for you guys. I can really recommend it. I also love that Holly from Journal with Dolly left little notes on some postcards she sent me, and we might actually get to see each other this summer. I still have to sort that out with her, but we are going to Oxford in July, my boyfriend and I, and we still have to figure out if we want to go other places than Oxford. And yeah, I'm just really excited. We've been wanting to go together for many years. That's a whole nother story that I'm gonna tell you sometime this summer. But okay, I'm just making a page in my normal journal with the goodies she sent. I love tipping things in. She sent so many beautiful things. Of course, I couldn't use all of them, but I tried my very best. So, I wanted to tell you about my two pen friends that I had. Sadly, we're no longer in contact, and the irony is in our social media world, I still haven't been able to find them again or get back in contact with them. So, you know. Anyway, the first pen friend I had, or properly had, was her name was Anna. She's from Canada, and I actually got her address, or got to know her, because we were on a train going through Germany with my parents, and I think I was like 12 or 13 years old, and we actually sat in the same train cabin with her grandparents, and I, like my 12-year-old self would, asked if she had any grandchildren or if she knew anybody, you know, around my age, and she gave me the address of her granddaughter, and we never actually met, which was quite unfortunate. We also, I'm not sure if we ever telephoned, I'm not sure, but I don't think so though. I don't think so. But we had plans to do that when I was over in Canada. Sadly, she lived quite far away from where I was going, where my family is in Canada, so we didn't manage to meet up. It would have taken like 2 or 3 days in the car. If you know Canada, it's huge. So sadly, we never got to meet, but I would look forward to her letters so much. So I would say I got a letter about once a month, once every 2 months, and I still have the letters. They're actually here in the Netherlands on the shelf, and I should really have another look at them and read through them because they're so nice. She would add drawings, and we were barely teenagers at that point, and it was just a very nice experience. And if you have children or grandchildren, do try to make them as enthusiastic about Pen Friends as I am. I know there are whole forums on the internet for people looking for Pen Friends, and I know on Instagram there's this whole trend, but I'm not quite sure if that's the same pen pal thing as I had with Anna. Also, another pen pal I had, which I really want to get back in touch with her, but I think we kind of lost touch. I met her in Oxford when I was doing a language course, and she was from Japan. Her name is Nanami. I love that name, by the way. And we would used to email. We did write one or two letters to each other, and I still have one of them, and it's so gorgeous. And yeah, that lasted for a few years too, and I'm really, really proud of the fact that I had pen pals. And from a very young age, I always wanted to have friends all around the world, and that was kind of my goal throughout my teenage years, to make friends from all over the world. And I remember Nanami would always sign her emails or letters with Nanami with eternal love, and I really loved that, and that was so cute. So yeah, that's the story of Nanami. They were both a little older than me, so I'm not sure if the addresses I have still are correct, and also the email addresses, I don't think they're still correct. So, you know, social media is great, but you also have to make a conscious effort to use it and to stay in contact. I did have friends from Belgium where we exchanged emails and letters and other people, but I think Nanami and Anna were the two main pen friends I had. I talked to my cousin who lived in England once or twice when I was very young, but yeah, I really miss receiving letters like that. Sometimes I feel like social media has diluted what human contact actually means, and that people think, oh yeah, I'm in contact with them, I saw their Instagram stories, I know what's going on, but actually that's so not what's going on, and then people don't reach out. And yeah, I'm really annoyed about that whole situation, especially if you have long distance friends that then just watch your stories instead of picking up the phone and calling, you know. So if you have long distance friends, go pick up the phone, go call them, go write them a card. Also, if you have family members that you haven't talked to in a while and you don't really want to pick up the phone because you're afraid it's awkward, I have the thing, I don't really like telephoning very much, so I'd rather think about what I'm going to say and write a nice note and send it. Please do. People really appreciate it, and it's more likely if you send it out that you will actually get some back too. And yeah, you have the opportunity to brighten someone's day, so go write those letters or postcards. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I used her stuff in my Fibonacci, which you can see here, and in my normal journal. I really loved the things she sent me, and it was so hard to choose what to put where and to actually use it, because sometimes, you know, we want to save stuff for a special occasion, but I try to use as much as I could. And if you have like things in your stash that you know you're not going to use but someone else would love it, then go ahead and send it to your journaling friend or somebody else, you know. I think Holly will be able to talk about this better, but I know that there are Facebook groups and whole pen pal snail mail exchange groups, so I have no experience with that, sadly. But I know that Holly has, so maybe she's going to talk about that. So go check out her video. She's awesome. And I'm so glad we could do this collab. And I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you enjoyed the rest of the video. I'm going to put on some music for the rest of the video. And I hope you have a lovely day. And go check out her video too. It's going to be linked down below. And talk to you again very, very soon. Thank you so much for watching. Have a lovely day. Bye-bye.